Good morning, everyone. I am so excited to share this vlog with you today because New York City is so close to my heart. I had the best of times there, the worst of times there. I met my now husband there. I had my first daughter there. I just, you know, love that city so much and all the memories that have come with it. And I realize it's a really challenging time to move there, but I still think a lot of people are gonna continue to move there. Rent is a lot lower there than when I lived there. And I think it's the best time to go before things start sort of moving and shaking once more. And they will, because it's a super resilient city. I experienced that when I moved there in 2012, when Hurricane Sandy hit, and it hit a lot harder in Brooklyn, and I couldn't get to work every day. Sometimes it took me 2 to 3 hours. I had to rely on the kindness of strangers just to take me into work. I had a neighbor who I didn't even know come knocking on my door a couple times. He said he was able to get a black car into work. I had to use drivers of people that I used to book for, you know, my clients. I mean, it was just whoever could help me, I had to just call in those favors, and it was not easy. I was there for just a couple of weeks or so when Hurricane Sandy hit. So I had to really, really be resourceful, and that is what I think it takes for someone to survive in New York City. You've got to draw on everything, and you have to be kind. Otherwise, nobody will help you. It doesn't necessarily mean that you'll be able to repay the favor, but always be appreciative and kind, and I think that will take you a really, really, really long way. So I really wanted to share these tips with you because I wish somebody shared these with me. Some of them are so practical and so simple, but you know what? I wish they would have been told to me because it would have sort of helped me wrap my head around how challenging living in such a city would be for me, or just anybody first moving there. So with that said, the first thing I want to talk about is make friends with people that you look up to and that you admire. Obviously, you can't force friendships, but really, if there's a connection with somebody and you really enjoy them and you enjoy each other's company, foster those relationships more, because those are people that are going to help you get on that better trajectory for your career or even your personal growth. And if you can find a mentor in someone as well, even at work, that you just get along with, even if you don't necessarily work in the same department, it really, really helps sort of push you to that next level in your life there. So, and if there's anything I've learned is that it's so cyclical there. Someone that you worked with, you know, at your first job could be someone that finally sort of is that last missing piece of the puzzle to get you that dream job that you wanted 6 jobs later. And you just don't know. I think everyone that you meet could be someone extremely important in your life somehow, or maybe not. But I treated it that way when I was there. You just don't know where that next sort of big moment will come from, whether it's a relationship, whether it's a career, whether it's just something that's super memorable to your life. So anyway, make friends with people that you really admire and that you, you know, look up to. And I strongly believe that you are the company that you keep. So the more company you keep that, you know, is doing really well for themselves, the better for you. And do not be afraid to take a job that is a little bit beneath you in responsibilities or that you're overqualified for. I just sometimes think that opportunities at really reputable companies or with really, really nice people that can help open other doors or mentor you in some way, I think sometimes that is much more vital than just making 10 or 20 and sometimes $30,000 more. I know the city is expensive and it's not easy to take a pay cut, but that is sometimes what you have to do. And sometimes, honestly, it's just better to have a job than no job. If that's all that's coming your way and it gets you up in the morning and dressed, take that job. Also, do not spend a lot of money on food. You will spend most of your money on drinks because that's just how it goes there if you want to go out and socialize. So don't spend all of your money on food. Pick about 3 places that you can get enough of a variety from that you enjoy, that is, you know, around the $10, $12 mark. It's really easy to spend, you know, $100 a day on food if you're just out and about. And most people are, they don't eat at home except for right now, obviously. So my three places that I basically ate at every day were Hale & Hearty, Sweet Green, and Nish Nush. I would still eat there every day today. And it didn't matter if you were making $20,000 a year or $2 million a year, everybody enjoyed that food. So don't spend your money on like your day-to-day food. If you wanna spend money on a nice restaurant, go ahead and do that once in a while, but don't spend it on your day-to-day food. The next one is probably one of my favorites, is walk with a sense of purpose, like you're going somewhere, even if you're not in a hurry. People will just appreciate you for this, and they will just like you better for this. People will get less frustrated with you and mutter less things under their breath. So just stop walking slow. If you want to stroll, go to a park. Go to Central Park, go to Battery Park. But the New York streets are not for strolling. You need a very warm and puffy coat for the winter. I don't care what kind of wool coat you have that you think is gonna cut it in that time, it's not. You need something that kind of makes you look like a marshmallow. I finally had to give in to that because I just, for so long, was like, no, a regular coat is just fine. It is not. Invest the money, spend a couple hundred dollars on a puffy coat, preferably one that goes to almost to your knees, because when that wind hits and it hits you just right, you will not be warm again. Do not waste your breath, your time, your energy on trying to fit in. It's not worth it. Everyone is unique anyway, and I believe that New York City actually lets you celebrate that. I was lucky enough to work in mostly creative environments. I did work in some corporate environments, but they had more of that sort of startup feel, so you could still dress how you wanted within reason, but really kind of just show your uniqueness every day. And that just really helps. There's no uniform, you do your hair how you want, you eat what you want, just show up and do your job and you can still be unique. So don't fit in, it doesn't help anyone. Do not expect to walk around in heels unless you're hailing a cab, unless your Uber's just around the corner, or unless you're just walking to a spot around the corner. They will get destroyed, you will never see them look the same. It is not worth it. You will go through more shoes in New York City than you will anywhere else you live in the world. Take the opportunity on your days off to just go explore different neighborhoods all around the city, and not just Manhattan. Go to Jersey, go to Brooklyn, go to Long Island. There's so much to explore. I, thankfully, the people I was meeting through work lived everywhere, so that got me out of the city really quickly. But if I didn't know anybody, I would pick a bakery or a coffee shop. Both are very important to me. And then I would just go and take the train and go walk around, even if it was just in 45 minutes. But it got me out of the house, and it got me from sort of sitting and being lonely as well. The best restaurants aren't the ones that have a full guest list or the flashing lights. They are the ones that are quaint, in deep dark corners somewhere on some small streets, whose staff has been there since the beginning of time. And you know, they've honed in on their menus, they're passionate about what they do, they're usually family owned. Go find those. You'll hear the best stories, meet regulars, and it's really fun, and it's so different from doing something that you think is just trendy and popular and, you know, everyone's wearing black altogether. There are also some wonderful places to eat in hotels, and a lot of the restaurants are part of the branding of the hotels. So usually a really famous chef is working there, or somebody with an amazing reputation. So they really, really take the time to make sure that you've had a wonderful experience, not just because of the food, but as a whole. So you come back, so you tell your friends, so if you've even traveled there, you're referring people to go to that hotel, and maybe then they'll stay at that hotel. So I think hotel restaurants are right up there for most of them anyway. And if you start exploring those, then you actually start learning where all the restrooms are in the city, and then that's never a problem. Always walk on well-lit streets. I know this seems like common sense, but there are so many small side streets in Manhattan especially that are so poorly lit because they're older, and maybe some of the lights are just dimmer as well. So just, you know, skip those, even if you have to sort of take the longer way home. It's just not smart. If there's an opportunity for someone to mug you or hurt you, it can happen. It's a safe city, but you also have to be completely aware. And if you're putting yourself in some kind of danger, or you know, or it doesn't feel right, trust that instinct and just go a different way. Go on a well-lit avenue. Avenues tend to be more well-lit, or spend the money on the taxi. This video is taking me a little bit longer to get through than I thought, so it brings me to my next point, is learn how to order anything very quickly, whether it's coffee, breakfast burrito, cocktails, anything from a bodega or a stand, just anything. Everyone will appreciate that. Everyone wants to be in and out. Everyone. If you don't know what you want, step out of line and get back in. The establishment will appreciate that. They want to move quickly. And the person behind you, I'm sure, is in a hurry. So just be prepared. If you don't know and you've never been there, look up the menu online. Almost all places have some sort of PDF online that you can look at. So do your research before ordering, or just know what you want. And the next one is have the pizza at 3 a.m. Don't bring it home. Walk down the street with the pizza the size of your head. It's super liberating. Just eat it walking around and then get home and go to bed, and it'll be easier because you won't be hungry. And the next one is more of a safety one. If you can afford to live in a doorman building, I would highly recommend it, especially as a female. I find that those buildings tend to be a little bit more well lit, and almost always the doorman is in front of the building, sometimes outside if it's a nice night. So you just feel sort of that safety when you're coming out of the cab, or if you're just turning the corner, and really helps when you're hauling groceries. So it's just helpful all around, and I really did find it to be just comforting, especially getting out of a taxi or an event at, you know, 2 a.m. when, you know, obviously not a lot of people are around in like the very, you know, niche neighborhoods where there's, you know, it's not Times Square and it's not Soho. Everywhere else is a little bit more quiet. The other one that I really love is when you start making money, I think you should absolutely treat yourself to hair blowouts and foot massages, specifically in Chinatown. I would say I would either alternate each one each week, depending on my schedule. And it was the best money I ever spent. I kind of wish I even did it even more. They are half the cost, if not 70% less, of what the rest of the country pays for these things. You will never have a chance to spend such little money on self-care as you can in Chinatown. Instead of buying that $20 drink, go get a 30-minute foot massage. It will change your afternoon. Or go get that blowout. You know, I just appreciated that so much. I have long hair, and I didn't always want to do my hair, so it was something that brought me a lot of joy. Don't run errands on the weekends. That tends to be the time that people travel to New York City, because that's the time that they have off of work. I would steer clear from Soho, Flatiron, Times Square, anywhere that there's those historic, popular buildings that people are visiting, because it's not just the outside that's really busy. It's all the restaurants and coffee shops and bakeries. It's anywhere that anybody can get a bite to eat surrounding those areas that are super busy. So if you're trying to get a bite to eat or you're running your errands, it's gonna take you twice as long and you'll be twice as annoyed. I'm happy to know that this is my very last one, and that is bring an umbrella with you wherever you go. It's just life's way that the day that you don't bring one is the day that you need one. There aren't massive downpours in the city, so you know, you can get away with not having one if you just have a hood that day, but sometimes there are, and you're gonna be left stuck there for a while, and that's not fun. And also, it is almost impossible to hail a cab or get an Uber on rainy days. I swear, people who don't normally take cabs or Ubers save their money for those rainy days, I guess, no pun intended, because that's when you want the car, right? So Ubers tend to be 3 to 4 times the price, which is a lot, because you're only going a mile at most usually, or you know, 2 if you're going across the island, but you are never going more than a couple miles, and you will spend a lot of money really quickly on an Uber. Not to mention they take a much longer time getting to you, and by then you could have walked halfway there, so not really worth it. Bring the umbrella. But anyway, with that said, I think that the best way to catch a cab on those rainy days is on a very, very busy corner, specifically one with either a big restaurant or a hotel or some kind of attraction that tends to be where people are getting in and out. Otherwise, you will not have any luck. You won't see any lights on those taxis. If you're just walking down the street hoping to hail a cab, it does not work. I probably could have done a second part of this video because there's a lot more that I can talk about with New York City, but I will do more vlogs in regards to how I grew my career there and how I was able to start a little contract job where I was essentially making no money to making six figures within a couple of years. And I'll be sharing some of my other work experiences as well. Please subscribe if you're interested. If not, hope to see you soon. Bye.